Hi, I'm Justin Smith, and this is The First Time. The first time I recorded an audio drama was for this thing that I'm promoting right now called Freaks, which is an Audible original coming out August 4th, which is 5 days before my birthday. So happy birthday to me. But it was a lot of fun. Had I done voiceover before that? I don't think I had. I remember when I was a kid, the first audition I ever had at an agency ever was a voiceover audition, and I just did not get it. I was like, how do I do this? How do I like act, but like you don't see my face? And so all my lines came out just like, and then run, you know, like very monotone. So I was a little nervous going into doing Freaks. Because I was like, it's gonna happen again. But then I kind of fell into it. I was like, oh, this, I should just like act more, just be a little bit more than I would normally be on camera and like try to feel it out in my voice. And it's also easier because it's different than a scene where you like, you shoot the whole scene, they yell cut, and then they give you notes and then you shoot it again. It's line by line. You get notes on how this line sounds, how it should sound, all this kind of stuff, and you just repeat it a couple of times until they get a good one. But it was a lot of fun. Technically, the first time I performed on stage was in kindergarten, but that wasn't a stage. That was like, it was a live reading, I guess, of the Three Billy Goats Gruff, where we just like took the story and like divided it into parts and then performed it for our parents collectively. And I remember we had little auditions where the teachers had the kids come up individually and like read parts of the book. And I was like, I need to be the troll. I want to be the troll so bad. This is my dream role. And so during my audition, I like put on a voice and I'm like, read it as a troll. I was like six. And the teacher was like, so wowed. And she's like, oh my gosh, you know, king of acting. And then I got the part, and I remember like twisting my hair in like gel and stuff and like changing my body language. I was an artist even back then, man. Back when I used to do commercials, when I used to audition for commercials, I auditioned for like a year or 2 years. I didn't get anything. And then when I was 15, I got an Apple commercial. It was an industrial Apple commercial. So it was for when you go into the Apple store and like all of the computers are like playing clips of random shit. It was that. And in my clip, I was like explaining how wind turbines worked. I was like a middle school reporter. And I'm like, I remember that my name was the name of an Apple employee, but I don't remember what it was exactly. But I was just like, I'm here and I'm reporting on wind turbines and they're a sustainable source of energy and yada, yada, yada. And I was the only one in the commercial that had lines. And so all the other kids were like trying to get close to me. And I was like, oh, wow, is this what it means to be popular? Because I had no friends before that. But and that was it. And then it played in the Apple store for like a year or two. It was literally just to explain how the iMovie maker worked. It was like, you can make anything. You can make a middle school report, you know? It was one of those. There's a scene in Fallen Kingdom where I have to like hold down Blue, the raptor, as Zia, played by Daniela Pineda, who I love, operates on her. And there's a shot of the blood squirting into my face as like a visual gag.
Oh my god, is that in my mouth?
And the director Jay Bayona told me that it was going to be CGI, like they were just going to in effects after the fact. And so I'm like, we're shooting the scene and I go to hold down and it fully just hits me directly in the uvula. Like my mouth was open, it just fully in the mouth. And I was like, oh my gosh. I wasn't too happy, but I wasn't upset. I just was like shocked. But he like pulled a lot of pranks on me on that set. A big part of my character was his fear and his anxiety. And so I had to like, he just wanted to get that as real as possible. And I'm all about like you know, doing the things that get a real reaction out of you. So I was like, sure, I'm down for this. But then the justice part of me was like, I don't like to be scared. The first time I played Pokemon probably was the cards, but it also could be Pokemon Gold, which is what I had on Game Boy Color. Speaking of Pokemon, look at what the hotel, I came back and the hotel had made me this like chocolate, like, this is so cool. That was like a pleasant surprise. I don't know how they, anyways, first time I played Pokemon was probably the cards with my sister. We would make up the rules because we didn't know how to read. And also the rules are so long and there's like so many intricacies and to like that game. So we would just like be like, oh, this one is cuter, so it beats that one, honestly. Or this one is electric, and electric obviously beats water, because if you put a toaster in the bathtub, then you're in, you're done. So that was probably the first time. It's the scene in Tim's dad's apartment where he walks in and Pikachu has trash everywhere and he's trying to like solve this memory.
So Pikachu?
Oh jeez.
And Ryan was on set that day. And I remember he was so nice and so cool. And we had already had like a week of rehearsals before that. But I, instead of looking at Ryan, I had to look at this puppet, this like yellow, janky looking version of what is the in the movie that this puppeteer was moving. And I was like, oh, okay, so I'm gonna have to get used to this. But I was like, at least I have an eye line. And until they were like, now we're going to take the puppet out and you're just going to have to remember where Pikachu was and how tall he was and how close to you he was. And you're going to look at like empty spaces and just track him at all times. So over the course of that movie, I got really good at, you know, doing that and imagining where he was in the space at all times. First time I met Elle was at the chemistry read for All the Right Places in London, actually. I flew out with a friend of mine who was also up for the role. But yeah, I walked in the room and I met her. She was really warm and nice. And it was the same time I met Brett Haley, too, the director. That was the first time I met her. But then later when we actually got onto set after I got the job, I remember like, it was like the second time meeting her that we were like doing a costume test or whatever, on camera and stuff like that. And we're standing next to each other and I go, hey, I just wanted to say like, you are in like one of my favorite movies from childhood. You were like the voice, you and your sister. And she's like, oh, My Neighbor Totoro. And I was like, oh wait, no, I meant Spirited Away. I was like, oh shit, no, that wasn't you, was it? I was like, I also like My Neighbor Totoro. That's also a good movie. I love that movie. And she's like, oh, yeah. But yeah, I remember being like, oh, fuck. I was like, this is my in. I'm going to be able to like start shooting the shit with her. And I fucked up.